हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ अरविंद पंडा। आई एम अ फोर्थ ईयर स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम यूपीएस देहरादून एंड करेंटली आई एम अ लीगल इंटर्न इन लेक्सस एंड कंपनी फॉर द मंथ ऑफ जून। एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्रेसिडेंशियल एंड पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट। सो मोर देन 50% ऑफ द वर्ल्ड टुडे हैज़ अ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट विच अलाउज फॉर अ पॉपुलर पार्टिसिपेशन थ्रू द इलेक्टोरल प्रोसेस। दिस डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेटिव और डायरेक्ट। In a direct democracy, political power is placed in the hands of all individual in the state who come together to make a decision. In a representative democracy, on the other hand, individual that are elected through the electoral process act as intermediaries between the people of the state and the policy decisions. Basically, a person elected by the people take decision on their behalf. So, now a representative democracy can be divided into parliamentary and presidential democracy. Now, let us talk about the presidential form of government. With the example of USA, a presidential system is also called a congressional system. It refers to a system of governance in which the president is the chief executive and is elected directly by the people. The head of the government does exist separately from the legislature. It is a form of government where three branches, legislature, executive and judiciary, exist separately and cannot dismiss or dissolve the other branch. While the legislature make the law, the president enforce them, and it is the court that is responsible for the exercising judicial duties. The origin of presidential form of government can be traced back to the medieval England, France and Scotland. Now, let us talk about the features of presidential system of democratic governments. President does not have nominal power. He has both the head and the executive of the head of the state. As the head of the executive, he has the ceremonial position. As the head of the government, he acts as the chief real executive. Now, president is directly elected by the people of electoral college. The president cannot be removed except through an impeachment procedure for a grave unconstitutional act. The president governs with the help of a small body of people, thus his cabinet. The president and his cabinet are not answerable to the legislature or the member of legislature. The concept of separation of power is clearly visible in presidential system. Now, let us talk about the parliamentary form of government. A parliamentary form of democracy is also known as cabinet form of government or the responsible government. It refers to a system of governance in which the citizens elect a representative of legislative parliament. This parliament is reasonable to make the decision and laws for the state. It is also directly answerable to the people. As a result of the election, the party with the greatest representative form the government. Its leader become the prime minister and perform various executive function along with the member of parliament appointed by the prime minister to the cabinet. The parties who lose the election form the minority and serve as opposition in the parliament. Attempts to create a system of parliamentary democracy were seen in European Revolution, and currently India is one of those countries who follows parliamentary form of government. Now, let us talk about the features of parliamentary form of government. The head of the state and the head of the government are different under the parliamentary form of government. It can be either bicameral or unicameral. A bicameral system usually consists of a directly elected lower house, which is in turn elects the upper house. The power of the government are not completely separated. The line between the legislature and the executive are blurred, as executive form the part of the legislature. This system is also characterized with majority party rule. The council of ministers in the system are collectively responsible to the parliament. Most of the time in this form of government, the cabinet proceedings are kept secret and are not meant to be dissolved in public. Now, if we come to a conclusion of both the form of government, the system of governance in countries differ depending on whether a country has a presidential or parliamentary system. There are some of the countries who have adopted a mixture of both this type as well. This system have multiple differences based on separation of powers, accountability, executive, etc. Both this system come with their own advantages and disadvantages. A country choose the system which suits it the most. The parliamentary system allows representative governments which is suitable in a diverse country like India. But for countries like USA, the presidential form is most suitable. So that's all for today's video. Hope you like it. Have a nice day. Thank you so much.